CH3CH and here is OH. This is the 1 degree alcohol, primary alcohol, 1 degree. The second one is CH3C, here is CH3H, bond OH, and this is 2 degree alcohol. And then CH3C, CH3, here is 3OH. Okay. 1 degree, there CH3 can be replaced by R in general. R we can also write. This alkyl group has tendency to donate shared pair of electrons, that is plus I effect, increasing electron density over carbon. And your OH is coming out in the form of negative, because oxygen is more electronegative. It carries a pair of electrons with that. So OH will come out from that carbon easily, which has less electron density. Which has more electron density, because OH comes out in the form of negative. Here carbon has some electron density. Here due to 2CH3, electron density over this carbon is more as compared to the first one. Am I clear to you? Bachcho, clear ho raha hai na? What I want to say? OH comes out from that carbon easily, which has more electron density. And here, 3CH3, 3 alkyl group, maximum plus I effect, you can see here. Maximum plus I effect. Therefore, this carbon has maximum electron density and OH comes out easily from this carbon. So, the order of reactivity, 3 degree alcohol will be more reactive than 2 degree alcohol and then 1 degree alcohol. This is the order of reactivity. Is it clear? So, in this order, the rate of reaction varies. If you take 1 degree alcohol as an example, here the condition is slightly different than 2 degree and 3 degree alcohols. And their chemical properties we have discussed earlier in Unit 10, haloalkenes, preparation of haloalkenes from alcohols. Okay, beta? There are a series of reactions like a reaction with halogen acid. We get a chloroalkane, bromoalkane, iodoalkane. Reaction with phosphorus halides. Again, we are going to get a chloro and bromoalkane, iodoalkane, like that. Reaction with ionyl chloride. Three reactions are there. Okay. So let us see once again these reactions. The first reaction is the reaction halogen see here alcohol CH. If you talk order of reactivity of halogen that we are discussing in detail, HCl, HBr and Hi. These are the three halogen acids we are using. HF is not used. Here HCl bond dissociation energy is more. HBr intermediate and Hi has the minimum bond dissociation energy. Therefore, the order of reactivity is like this. Halogen acid Hi will be more acidic, more reactive in this reaction. Okay, beta. So let us start with an example. CH3CH2OH combines with HCl in presence of, do you remember the presence? Do you remember? What is the presence here? This is called Luca reagent, mixture of HCl and anhydrous ZnCl2. Anhydrous ZnCl2, zinc chloride. Okay. So it gives here OH along with it comes out in the form of H2O and we get CH3, CH2, Cl plus H2O. Anhydrous is needed to stop any chance of reverse reaction. If this alcohol is 2 degree, then the reaction becomes faster. If this is 3 degree alcohol, it will be much faster. Like here, CH3C, CH3OH combines with HCl in presence of anhydrous ZnCl2. Here, heat is required. And in this case, heat is not required. It is more reactive and it gives CH3CH. Here is CH3, here Cl plus H2O. This is the difference. 2 degree alcohols are more reactive in this respect, where OH participates. And if it is 3 degree, CH3, here CH3, here is OH, combines with HCl. This reaction is going on within few seconds. Anhydrous ZnCl2, within no time, we get the product. Here it takes some time, 1 to 2 minutes. And in this case, we get these two products until it is heated. Without heating, we won't get the product. CH3C, CH3, CH3, here is Cl plus H2O. Okay? The reaction is clear to you. There is one advantage of this reaction. This property is used to distinguish primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohol. That is called Lucas test. If the question is given, how can you distinguish primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohols? How to answer? Simply, statement. Alcohol are allowed to mix these three samples of alcohol. We are given three samples. We are not knowing which one is 1 degree, which one is 2 degree, and which one is 3 degree. Then take a sample of alcohol and mix with anhydrous ZnCl2 and HCl. If you are getting this type of product, means here we get cloudiness. This is called cloudiness. Cloudiness. Cloudiness, these two are not going to mix together. Alcohol, sorry, haloalkane, chloroalkane, and water, they are not going to mix together. Simply, they form two different layers, but it is formed afterward. Initially, water and haloalkane mixture is obtained, and that mixture is not totally mixed, and it seems like cloudiness. Turbide solution is obtained, turbide mixture is obtained at the beginning. Afterward, two different layers. One layer is water layer and then haloalkane layer. Initially, we get cloudiness. Where we are getting cloudiness within no time, few seconds, that alcohol will be up 3 degrees. That is the advantage. If it takes 2 to 3 minutes or maximum 5 minutes to get cloudiness, that sample will be 2 degree alcohol. 2 degree alcohol takes 2 to 5 minutes. And if it is not obtained without heating, that sample will be 3 degree alcohol. Hello? Okay, beta. Just mic is continuous running, that I'm closing that. So, are you able to hear me? Hello, bachcho. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Tell me, please.
Yes, sir.
Can
you hear me? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Very good. So, this is the reaction with halogenation. and its application, its advantage, its use. This reaction is used to distinguish primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohols. And it is one of the common questions. How can you distinguish primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohols? By doing some chemical test. This is not only the test. This is one of the important tests. This can be used to distinguish the alcohols. Okay. This is the one reaction. This reaction we have studied in the unit 10 while preparing of haloalkanes from alcohols. Okay. This is the one reaction. Second property, second reaction. Do you remember what is the second reaction? When is reaction with halogen acid? If you take HCl, reaction is slower, HBr somewhat faster, and HY, the reaction will be the fastest one. For HBr, it's the same reaction. If you take HBr, alcohol is like a CH3, CH2, OH, combines with HBr. Then what we have to take here? HBr is not stored like HCl. It is prepared during the reaction. There is the source of HBr, and that may be KBr, that may be NaBr and H2SO4. A source of HBr is used. The reaction is proceed in the same manner. H and OH comes out in the form of H2O, and we get CH3, CH2, Br plus H2O. Okay, Peter? This is for bromo, and in the same fashion, if it is 1 degree, reaction will be the slowest, and 2 degree, it is faster than the 1 degree, and 3 degree, reaction will be the fastest one. Because of the plus I effect and its reason, we have studied the order of reactivity, we have discussed at the beginning. If we take HI, then it is CH3, CH2OH plus HI. HI is also cannot be stored like HCl. It is prepared during the reaction. And we have to take its source like Ki and H3PO4, Ki and H3PO4 or H2SO4 which produce HI. And this HI is going to combine in the same fashion and form iodoalkane H3CH2I plus H2O. This reaction with halogen acid. Okay. This is the one type reaction, one first reaction where OH of alcohol participates. And second type of reaction is, do you remember what is the second reaction? How to prepare haloalkane from alcohol? One is by the use of halogen acid. What is the second method? In this way, you can remember, you can revise the previous topics which we have studied. That is the phosphorus halides. Reaction with phosphorus halides. Phosphorus halides. Phosphorus halides. What are the formula? Is it a phosphorus halides? Phosphorus halides are two. One is a phosphorus trichloride, and there is phosphorus penta. Phosphorus trihalide and phosphorus pentahalide. That is PCl3, PCl5. Chlorine forms two, and bromine only PBr3 and iodine Pi3. PBr5, Pi5, they are not stable. Even PBr3, Pi3 also, they are not much stable. So the reaction is, we have to take alcohol, CH3, CH2OH plus PCl5, phosphorus pentachloride. What should be the product here? OH replaced by Cl. That is the simple. OH replaced by Cl, we are getting chloro. CH3, CH2, Cl, and the remaining Cl, they are coming out in the form of POCl3, and hydrogen comes out in the form of HCl. In this way, there are five Cl. 5Cl this side and 5Cl. This is a way to remember how to, what is the byproduct in this case. That is POCl3, phosphorus oxychloride and HCl. When we take PCl3, the byproduct is different. CH3, CH2, OH combines with PCl3. The product is in the same fashion. OH replaced by Cl. Here is CH3, CH2, Cl plus it. Here the another product is H3PO3. Here we get an oxoacid of phosphorus H3PO3 plus HCl. H3PO3. To balance this one, we have to take thrice of this. And here is no any other product. Thrice of this. This is the way to complete the reaction. PCl3, we get H3PO3 and PCl5. We get the byproduct POCl3 and HCl. In the same fashion, PBr3 and PI3 also combine. Like a piece of CH3, CH2, OH plus a PBr3 source, we have to take phosphorus and bromine. We are going to get thrice of CH3, CH2, Br plus H3PO3. This reaction is all required condition. We have discussed in the unit 10, preparation of alloalkene from alcohol. That preparation we are revising. This all preparation we have discussed there. This is the second method. And here, in third method, we are using thionyl chloride that is specially used to get chloroalkene from alcohols. The one reacted is alcohol, another reacted is thionyl chloride, SOCl2. Third one, reactions with thionyl chloride. Thio refers to sulfur. Thio means sulfur. Here, CH3, CH2, OH plus SOCl2. Formula of thionyl chloride is SOCl2. And condition is pyridine PY. Pyridine is repeated as PY. Pyridine. Pyridine is a mild base. Pyridine formula, here it is like this. Here is pyridine. It is a mild base. It has a pair of electrons over nitrogen that can be donated. So this mild base is required here to check the reverse reaction, to check any possibility of the reverse process. So the product is CH3, CH2, Cl plus SO2, sulfur comes out in the form of SO2 and Cl comes out, additional Cl comes out in the form of HCl. Out of these three methods, convert into alkene, this is the best method. Why is it so? Why this is called best method? Do you remember it? Yes, beta? Ketan, Somil, can you tell? Aditi, why this method is called best method to convert alcohol into haloalkene? Yes. Byproducts are the gases. Very good. Yes, you are remembering. This SO2 is the byproduct, comes out, and HCl is the byproduct, comes out. HCl basically gas. They come out. That's why we are getting the pure alkene. If we add required quantity of these, equimolar quantity, then we are getting pure chloroalkene. No purification is needed. That's why it is the best method to convert alcohol to get a chloroalkene from alcohols. This is the reaction. Reactions involving OH of alcohol. This is the type of reaction. One more reaction is there. When CH3, CH2, that is fourth reaction with the ammonia. Reaction with ammonia. CH3, CH2, OH combines with the ammonia, NH3. And condition is Al2O3, aluminium chloride, Al2O3, and 633 Kelvin of temperature. We get amine. This OH replaced by NH2. OH along with one hydrogen from here comes out in the form of H2O. OH from here, one hydrogen from ammonia comes out in the form of H2O. And NH2 which is left here takes the place of alcohol, CH3, CH2, NH2. This is an amine, ethyl amine, 1 degree amine. This amine is further going to combine with alcohol, CH3, CH2, OH. It combines with alcohol again. And here, this second hydrogen comes out along with OH in the form of H2. Three hydrogen in ammonia. In first step, one hydrogen comes out in the form of H2. Here again H2, and we are getting CH3, CH2, NH, CH2, CH3. This is 1 degree amine, and this is 2 degree amine. Why is it 2 degree? In amines, degree is decided by nitrogen, not by carbon. Here, nitrogen is connected with one carbon, that's why 1 degree. Here, this nitrogen is connected by 2 carbon atoms, that's why its degree is 2. And this is again combining with alcohol because one hydrogen is left, CH3, CH2, OH. And here, this hydrogen along with OH comes out in the form of H2O. And we are getting CH3, CH2, N, CH2, CH3, and here is CH2, CH3. And the degree of this amine is 3 degree because nitrogen is connected with 3 carbon atoms. Are you able to see the reaction? No. 1 degree, 2 degree, and 3 degree alcohol can be obtained. Here, this can be written here. This is obtained like this. It can be written CH3, CH2, thrice N. Here it can be written H3CH2 twice N, 2 degree. In this way, you are going to get the mixture of primary, secondary, and tertiary amines. Okay, these are the aliphatic amines. This is the another reaction. This we have not discussed in the unit 10. Okay, beta? These are the second type of reactions, B type of reactions. Now come to the C type of reactions. Reactions involving both C-type reaction. Reactions involving both alkyl and hydroxyl. Hydroxyl group. Both means complete molecule going to participate in the reaction, both alkyl and hydroxyl group. So what should be the reaction? Here, one reaction is dehydration. Dehydration. Dehydration reaction. Dehydration means removal of OH along with hydrogen. And this reaction is, if it is written like this, here is a OH, this is an alcohol, maybe 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree. In presence of acid, H positive, and a proper temperature, heat is needed, proper heating is required. This H2O comes up, OH from carbon, OH from the next carbon comes out in the form of H2O, minus H2O, and going to form alkene in a preparation. We have converted alkene into alcohols by hydration, acidic hydration. And see here, once again, by acidic dehydration, we convert alcohol into alkene. Okay? So, what is the mechanism of this reaction? Mechanism. Let us see the mechanism also. Some reactions we need mechanism, not for all reactions. Mechanism, sometimes there are six exams, right? The mechanism of this particular reaction, it will be of a 2 marks, sometimes 3 marks. Molecular symmetry in the, okay, beta, kya pucha aapne? Some question was put up by students. I could not see that. Okay. Mechanism, step one. First step is protonation. This acid is there. It protonates an alcohol. The alcohol is like this. CH3 bond CH2 and here is OH. Oxygen has pair of electrons plus H positive. H positive is coming from acid, sulfuric acid. This lone pair is attracting this hydrogen ion. And hydrogen ion joined to the oxygen. That's why it is. This is a proton. This is called protonation process. And the product is CH3 bond C. Here is H. Here is O. And here is H. And here is H. A pair of electron left. And a positive charge arises over here. This step is fast. Protonation step is fast. First step is fast one. In step 2, second step, this protonated alcohol going to convert into carbocation, and that is the slow process. That step is slow, and the reaction is like this. CH3CA, here is H, here is H, here is O, H, lone pair, and here is the positive charge. This shared pair of electron transferred to this side. This bond is going to break. And shared pair of electrons shifted towards the electronegative oxygen and going to change into a carbocation. This positive charge shift towards this carbon. As the shared pair of electrons shifted towards this side, this positive charge disappears. And here the positive charge arises because its one electron is lost. And the product is CH3 bond C, here is H, and here is the positive charge. This is the carbocation plus H2O. H2O comes out. Okay? Then, in final step, step 3, let me write step 3 upside. Step 3 here. Step 3, this carbocation going to change into alkene. Finally, alkene. Here is H, here is H, here is the positive charge. This step is slow. Here, this hydrogen, its lone pair, shared pair of electrons shifted to that side. And hydrogen comes out in the form of H ion, hydrogen ion. Here is H, double bond C. Here is H plus H positive. At the beginning, H positive involves protonation step. And finally, H positive becomes free for further protonation. This is the mechanism of acid dehydration. Okay, beta? Clear over? Mechanism? This is the second mechanism. What mechanism we have studied earlier? Acidic hydration, that mechanism. Molecular symmetry is in syllabus or not? Molecular symmetry means? Molecular symmetry. I don't understand what actually you want to ask. Molecular symmetry means what? It is related with a particular topic. Otherwise, you can go for the syllabus. Varsha, optical isomerism, haloalkenes, there is a sister, there is a dextro and levo rotatory, that is in your syllabus. So, optical isomerism, optically active, asymmetric center, dissymmetric molecule, and when there is more than one chiral carbon, then there should not be planar symmetry. This type of concept is in your syllabus. It is in your syllabus. Optical isomerism is in your syllabus, especially with reference of haloalkenes and alcohols. Alcohol also can be taken as an example. Okay, Varsha. Step 3 is clear. This is the mechanism, second mechanism which is in your syllabus. One more mechanism is there, that is the mechanism of esterification. Three mechanism in your syllabus. Acidic hydration of alkenes, acidic dehydration of alcohol, and one more mechanism, esterification. That mechanism we will discuss in the next unit. Now, the examples. Some examples of acidic dehydration. CH3, CH2, OH. In presence of concentrate H2SO4, concentrate H2SO4, temperature is 443 Kelvin. 443 Kelvin temperature, remember the temperature, it is the important temperature, 443 Kelvin. This OH along with one hydrogen from the next carbon comes out and we get CH3, CH2 double bond, CH2 plus H2O. This is 1 degree alcohol. Okay. If it is 2 degree alcohol, CH3, CH, degree of alcohol is 2 degree alcohol, then here we need the concentration of alcohol is like lesser. And here we take 440 Kelvin. The concentration is 80 to 85%. 80% H3PO4. We can take H2SO4 also. 85% H2SO4. And temperature is 440 Kelvin. Because 2 degree alcohol in this respect more reactive than 1 degree because of the Mohr plus I effect. And the product will be CH3, CH, and here is CH2 plus H2O. Condition is going to change because this alcohol is more reactive in this reaction. And if it is 3 degree, CH3, C, CH3, here is CH3, OH. Here it needs only 20% alcohol, 20%, see the strength of alcohol, 20% H3PO4 or H2SO4, and temperature is quite lesser. This temperature is 358 Kelvin. And we are getting the same product, alkene, CH3C, CH3, here double bond, CH3. Double bond CH2 plus H2O. Hydrogen from any one of alkyl, they all are same type. This CH3, CH3, from anywhere, we can remove one hydrogen along with OH comes out in the form of H2O. So, conditions are going to change. 1 degree less reactive, condition is somewhat drastic. 2 degree somewhat more reactive, condition is moderate, and the condition is slightly different than the previous reactions. That is because of the order of reactivity of alcohols are different. This is acidic dehydration by sulfuric acid. If condition is now going to change, if alcohol is in excess and temperature is below 443 Kelvin, this temperature, then what should be the product? See the reaction. एल्कोहल CH3 CH2 OH, इट इज इन एक्सेस. टू मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ एल्कोहल इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेट H2SO4 एंड टेम्परेचर 413 केल्विन. रिमेंबर दिस टेम्परेचर अगेन 443 एंड हियर इज 413 केल्विन एंड एल्कोहल इज इन एक्सेस. So what is going to happen? There is no complete protonation. Only few molecules of alcohol get protonated by acid, and some unprotonated molecules are also there. They are going to combine together and form an ether, CH3, CH2O, CH2, CH3, plus H2O. We are going to get ether, diethyl ether in this case. Are you following the point? If the condition is like this, concentrate sulfuric acid is lesser in quantity as compared to alcohol and temperature is 413 Kelvin. While completion of the reaction, if the condition is given like this, we have to take care whether we are going to get alkene or ether. Its reason, what is the reason behind this? Actually, when alcohol is in excess, combines with H2SO4, it is going to form CH3, CH2, HSO4, CH3, CH2, HSO4, plus H2O. This is the one. And another, CH3, CH2, HSO4, plus CH3, CH2, OH, alcohol, it is going to form ether, CH3, CH2O, CH2, CH3, plus H2SO4. Because here, protonation, this is that I have written it this way. This can also be written. Or we can write a protonated alcohol, and then it is going to combine with unprotonated alcohol. That is also correct. Okay, better? This is the second dehydration. And another method, one more method is there. By the use of alumina, we can also dehydrate alcohol. Like alcohol is CH3, CH2, OH. In presence of Al2O3 alumina and temperature is 633 Kelvin, 633 Kelvin, this temperature, there is complete dehydration and formation of alkene takes place, plus H2O. Alkene formation takes place when alumina is heated up to 633 Kelvin and we are passing alcohol over time. And if temperature is below that, CH3, CH2, OH, alcohol is passed over alumina, L2O3, and temperature is 513 to 513 to 523 Kelvin. Any temperature in between 523 can be written. There is partial dehydration, no complete, partial dehydration, and we are going to get CH3, CH2O, CH2, CH3. We are going to get an ether instead of alkene. Partial dehydration takes place. Okay, beta? These are the second type of reactions. Where third type of reaction, where we have studied only one type, and other reaction, oxidation and dehydrogenation. These are the two more reactions I will take in the next class. Okay, any doubt? In today's class, you can ask about that if you are having, you are feeling any doubt. Okay, beta? Just before, don't leave. I am going to mark your attendance once again. Many students are like, please don't leave the class. This is today's class, no more. But some attendance, some new students are in here. I want to mark their attendance. Ujesh is 139. This is available here, and 141, 142. Yes, it's there. Utkarsh Goyal, are you listening me? Are you level here, Utkarsh? And at 12th C, your attendance will be marked. Okay? Your attendance I will mark. Don't leave. Just I am marking your attendance once again. If you don't leave the class just now, just wait for a few seconds. Aman is not here. Akriti, Chidesh, are you available?
Sir, Aman is present.
Then,
sir,
is Lakshakar. If you are available, you are missing me, then you say your attendance. Then Hardik Chauhan, Hardik Singhada. Aman is available. Yes, beta. See your attendance presence. And then Chidesh, Devashish. Then Divyansh Chaudhary is available here. Number 12. Prajya, yes, beta. Your presence I have marked. Then Hardik Hitendra Sisodia.
Sir, Hitendra Sisodia present.
Number 18. Hitendra is here. Yes, beta. And then Manisha Irwal, number 24. Manisha. Monish Ahir, Monish 25. Nonit 26. Nonit. Nisha 27. Then Rahul Singh.
Rahul Salvi present.
Rahul Singh is. Say your presence, I'm marking here. Ritu is also present. 38. Suryans Verma.
42 present, sir.
39. Suryans present. Utkarsh. Roll number, no. Thank you, Beta. Thank you. Thank you all. Varsha, thank you very much, Beta. Thank
sir,
you very much.
Number 4 also.
Next class, I will take oxidation of alcohol and dehydrogenation. Oxidation and dehydrogenation of alcohols. Thank you. Thank you very much.